Okay, hello. Here we are. The second part of the video is about the guide number 7. In the first part, we talk about the grammar focus, future tenses, and we checked the questions about the topic hope for the future. You remember about Paulina? These are the same that I show you in the video. Okay, the reading comprehension, and here we are. Today, we're going to focus on the phrasal verbs in a context, okay? Las frases verbales, literal. Frase verbal consiste en un verbo más un adverbio o una preposición. Algunas frases verbales son literales, es decir, no cambian el orden. Y aquí tenemos algunos ejemplos. I wanted to move back home. Move plus back. La frase verbal es move back. ¿Cuál es el verbo? Move. La palabra move, que es el verbo, es lo que va a ir cambiando, ya sea presente, pasado, futuro, gerundio. Pero la preposición no se altera, o sea, no se toca. It took away all hope for the future. Take es el verbo, el pasado took. She grew up in a small village. Grow es el verbo. El pasado sería grew. En este tipo de actividad que se relaciona con la estructura gramatical, especialmente los verbos jóvenes necesitan repasar los verbos regulares e irregulares. En sus libros, en la parte de atrás del libro, ustedes tienen una cantidad enorme de verbos. Si no lo tienen, traten de conseguirse uno, fotocopiarlo y pegarlo en su cuaderno. Porque si no sabemos los verbos, no podemos entender las phrasal verbs. Phrasal verbs tiene que ver con verbos, ya sean regulares o irregulares. So, what you have to do for this class is to complete the sentences with a word from the box. You have question number one, I mean sentence number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And the prepositions are out, at, down, on, back, off. Okay? Here we have a picture. The second activity, what do you have to do? You have to look at the pictures and write one sentence with each phrasal verb. Throw something away. Try something on. Look for something. Turn something off. Turn around. Pick something up. You have to look at this picture and you have to make one sentence according to the different situation. Okay? You must write it in your copybook. Activity number 3, complete the sentences with a phrasal verb from the exercise number 2. Read them aloud. This is the exercise number 2. These are the phrasal verbs, and these are the sentences. What you have to do is to complete with these words. Help me. You have to look for these expressions, okay? Activity number 4, match the phrases with the pictures. You have picture number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And the expression are, look up a word, break up with someone, take care of a baby, run out of milk, get along with somebody. Okay, you have to think about the meaning of these phrasal verbs and think about the pictures. You have to do in your copybook. And then we have here an important information. It says, some phrasal verbs are idiomatic. It said, I gave up my job because I was bored. I stopped. Give up. ¿Cierto? Darse por vencido o también detenerse, pararse. Aquí significa me detuve. I gave up my job because I was bored. Como que abandoné. Abandoné. Paré mi trabajo. She picked up English from the children. It means that learned it little by little. El significado acá es como diferente a lo que uno puede ver generalmente en los textos. Por eso se dice que es idiomatic. The plane took off late, left the ground. Okay? It's took off, el mismo que left the ground, en este contexto. Now, activity number 5, you have to complete the sentences with the phrasal verb from the exercise number 4 in the correct form. Read them aloud. Here you have to complete the sentences with some phrasal verbs from here. Okay? This is number 4. And after that, you have to talk about you. Just think about you, and honestly speaking, tell me, where do you Do you still live in the same house? What do you think are the missing words here? Okay, you must complete the question with one of the phrasal verbs on this page in the correct form. I want you to complete the question, please, and answer them in your copybook. And the message for you guys, you must read the message, write and translate it in your copybook. The future depends on what we do in the present. Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, guys, have a wonderful week. You know, any question you have, send me an email or just talk with the teacher assistants. And don't forget that we have to be optimistic and positive. Okay? Bye-bye, guys. Have a nice weekend. Have a nice week. Esperando.